Guri, how did you manage to get one of the worst ships in this entire planet?
Cut me a break. It was cheap. And besides, it's not threatening, so no one's gonna want to shoot at us.
But it's so slow. We're not gonna get anywhere fast. Oh, looks like we're here.
Initiating locking procedures. Alright, Leebo, you stay with the ship. Same as before. Me and Dash are gonna figure out what's going on. And, keep the engine hot, just in case.
You know, I always want to say, oh, why don't you take me with you? But after the last couple of days, I don't think I want to.
Whoa. Talk about taking a step into a history book. Looks just like the Clone Wars. Ugh, I hate the smell of a hospital. Even if this is just a cloning facility, it smells like chemicals.
Wait a second, Dash, do you see that up ahead? I don't need to tell you what that is.
What in the... I guess if you want clones, you'd gotta make a bunch. Let's see. Well, from here, it looks like that their vital signs are all flat. I think these clones might be dead.
We can only guess until we find a computer. They've got to have a central one. Plug into the mainframe? Huh. These computers are just like the ones the old Xizor used to purchase behind closed doors. I guess it didn't think of anything over the time, but I suppose it makes sense. If I remember correctly, give me a moment.
Sleep mode disabled. Current cloning process 0% complete. Unknown user detected. Please register.
Register? Why would you register yourself first?
Designation BACTA. Biomedical Auxiliary Control Terminal Assistant.
Auxiliary?
It's a helper computer. It probably does all the background work for creating clones.
Alright, BACTA. I'm Candorous.
Just use your real name.
Alright, sheesh. I'm Dash Rendar. I'd like to see the progress on clones.
Confirm, Mr. Rendar. The cloning status of pods 1 through 80, excluding 66, have permanently ceased as the needed genetic material has become unusable.
66 was probably our Xizor's pod.
Why is the genetic material unusable?
While the primary DNA of user Prince Xizor is perfectly functional, the additional DNA of unauthorized user Shane Palpatine was introduced hastily, and has ruined the other batches before they could be completed.
Wait a minute. The Emperor? Back to why was the additional DNA introduced?
The last entry of user Prince Xizor describes an attempt to achieve, quote, immortality and great power by secretly acquiring the unauthorized user's DNA.
Seems like Xizor didn't think anyone would ever find this place. Otherwise, it would have been locked up way tighter than it is.
Alright, well, we know why the other batches failed. But why did the one batch survive? Why did 66 survive?
The 66th batch was modified to be the only one to be produced in double the time. It was the only one to grow to adulthood, but as a result, suffers intense mental degradation and numerous health issues. The user who released it was Dr. Nadia.
The doctor sacrificed herself at Xizor's lab.
If the other batches died on their own through normal growth, how long does batch 66 have to live?
Approximately 2 months, 7 days, 14 hours, and 21 minutes starting now.
So you're saying Xizor's already a foot in the grave even if we never found this place?
Affirmative.
I kind of figured it wasn't just a bad case of memory loss. And to think Xizor's already knocking on Hell's door.
Well, then you and Xizor have something to share in common with each other. Considering we outnumber you 2-1, and, well, you get the picture.
I wouldn't be so hasty. My man have orders to blow up your craft if they see my vitals drops. I'd act with a little bit more caution than that.
If his men are still near the ship, then I can take them out while you deal with him.
Okay, I'll chat this guy. Try to buy you some time.
Who's ready to dance? Are you telling me there's not more of you out there? Well, guess I better double back to Dash.
Good. I was hoping she'd let me talk to you alone. Part bastards are the last of Xizor's men. Talk about a parting gift.
Alright, we're alone. What's your deal?
I'll be honest with you. I knew to at least a fair degree that Xizor was on his way out. I only stayed with him to get a chance of getting to you. Get my vengeance on you.
Vengeance? I don't even know who you are.
I didn't expect you to. But I remember you. From the day we met. Xizor's palace on the day you, him, and me all died. According to the galaxy. I was told to patrol the lower levels of my squad. We heard about an intruder alert, which of course was you and your rebel friends. I was guarding the upper staircase when I heard you blasting through all my men. Good men, you slaughtered without a second thought. And then you came up the stairs before I could even blink. You gunned me down, just like the rest. When I woke up, an alarm was blaring and the palace was crumbling apart, so I booked it everything. As far as anyone knew, I was dead, so I waited. My research to find the man who cost me my biggest chance in life. And when I heard Xizor had come back, I couldn't have signed on faster.
That's it? That's why you've been helping Xizor bring back his criminal empire?
Yes. No cost is too great to give you what you deserve for slaughtering my men and my chances at rising the ranks.
Slaughtered? You act as if they weren't going to shoot me the first chance they got. They were paid to shoot me just as I was paid to shoot them. We were both doing it for the money. Me, your men, you too, even now! The only thing that mattered was who shot first. And I just so happened to shoot first.
Huh. You know, you and I really aren't that different. We both only really care for the cash and revenge. Just like you now. But with Xizor.
That's where you're wrong, pal. After all this, I might not even kill this clone. It's not the same man, and he's on his way out anyway. I just care about making sure he doesn't hurt other people.
Like your family? Like your brother, Stanton? Yeah. Maybe you're right. Maybe you're right and I'm wrong. But I know for certain that you're right about one thing that matters. The only thing that matters is who shoots first.
And here I was thinking maybe you'd finally gain some sense.
I've got enough sense to know that I've come too far to back down now. Nothing's gonna stop me from getting my revenge, do you hear me? Nobody! Not your HRD, not Xizor, and certainly not you.
Sorry, Captain. I'd come all this way for revenge, too. And you turn into this. If this is what I'm gonna become. Once you have eliminated Rendar, return to the R&D tower on Scarif. Scarif? Where the hell is that? Huh? Good. You're back. You guys didn't give you any trouble?
If I could break a sweat, I would.
Cool. Now, you might tell me if you know anything about a Scarif?
Scarif? It's an Imperial world. It used to be pretty top secret before the Death Star blew up. Not sure about now. I do know of coordinates, though.
You haven't won here. You and your bastard friends are gonna join me in a big old mushroom cloud send-off. I just activated the self-destruct. The work will go on. You didn't do nothing here except seal your own death warrants. And Rendar, I'll see you in hell.
Captain, there's lightning coming out of the water, so come back to the ship, please.
Come on, Dash, we gotta get out of here now.
All employees proceed to the emergency car at the bottom platform. about to be